Is this alpaca story? Is this from Florida?
Yeah.
All right, now this is kind of a sad story, right? Dealing with alpacas. All right, let's get to this real quick.
Doritos, Cheez Nips, and whole peanuts. That's what a man was seen dumping into the Creekside Animal Hospital field that a baby alpaca later found.
All right, so there was a guy who was feeding alpacas at this alpaca field in Florida, feeding them Doritos.
And Cheez Nips.
Cheez Nips and peanuts. That does not seem healthy, really, for any animal.
Lay's, Doritos, we would just see him dumping chips over the fence, feeding these guys, kind of a few days in a row. Yeah.
The animal hospital says it spent 36 hours trying to save Ollie. In a Facebook post, worker said, "We've had a problem with a gentleman in a blue car consistently dumping inappropriate food into a field several times per week."
All right, so this guy, it's the same guy in a blue car who comes to this alpaca field and feeds alpacas Doritos and Cheez Nips. Now, the sad part is this alpaca Ollie ended up dying because it ate too many Doritos and Cheez Nips. Who knew that was bad for alpacas? But you learn something new every day on our show. So they're now looking for this guy who was just randomly feeding alpacas. He probably thought he was doing a nice thing. Oh, alpacas, they'll eat anything. Alpacas seem like the kind of animal that would love Doritos and Cheez Nips.
Let me get these Cheez Nips.
Apparently not so much, though. Because it killed this alpaca in Florida.
We have spoken to him on at least four separate occasions. Neighbors told me they see people give animals food all the time.
All right, well, I mean, lesson learned here is don't just feed random animals who you have no idea what their stomachs can take, what sort of diets they're on, because this guy thought, maybe thought he was doing a nice thing.
I mean, you drive by, you think, oh, look at that nice, fluffy alpaca.
That alpaca looks like it wants Doritos. The alpaca does not want Doritos, despite the alpaca probably devouring the Doritos and Cheez Nips. It's not good for it. An alpaca ended up dying in Florida. By the way, an alpaca is a very, it's a llama looking like animal, right?
Yeah,
llamas and alpacas are a little similar, but different, I think. I don't know the difference. Don't care to look it up. However, though, Bob, can you look up alpaca mating for me? Because I believe we have seen llamas mate before, right? Let me see. Hold on. Do I have llama mating noises over here? I think we have llama mating noises, right? Haven't we heard a llama mate before?
I believe so.
All right, hold on. I got llama mating. This is the noises that llamas make while they mate. All right. Now, I feel like an alpaca mating noise is going to be very similar to that, right? Do you have alpaca mating noises over there?
I do.
All right, hold on. Let me get to this. Alpaca. These are alpaca mating noises. Again, don't feed alpacas Doritos and Cheez Nips if you learn anything from our show today. And now it's the, wow. I should play the intro, right? What am I doing here?
Yeah, seriously.
Let's make this official here because this is a new animal noise we are bringing to the show. So here is our official animal mating noise intro here.
Who's ready for an educational adventure in nature? Some wild animals decided to make sweet love and share their beautiful song with the world. It's time for Animal Mating Noises with Mikey and Bob.
And the voice behind that wonderful animal mating intro was Bob from a few weeks ago when he completely lost his voice. Beautiful. And again, here are the mating noises of an alpaca. I mean, it sounds just like a llama, right? Llamas and alpacas have very, very similar mating noises. Wow.
Oh, boy.
Yeah.
Oh, my.
Whoa. Okay, it seems like it got a little feisty there at the end, right? Seemed like everything was going just okay, and then it seemed like you got a little feisty. Yeah, there we go.
All right,
alpaca. There you go. If you learned something else from the show today, it's llamas and alpacas have very similar mating noises. I would even say if I was a llama, I might confuse an alpaca for a llama. There may be a lot of llama-alpaca crossbreeding happening because they both honestly just sound like this. You hear that in the field. You don't know if you're getting a llama or an alpaca.
It's nature.
It is nature. This has been Animal Mating Corner with Mikey and Bob.